be around?
How much longer do you need? You have 3 days.
I'm going to get more time up there. I need another week at least.
Are you joking?
No, do you know how much stuff there is up there?
A week?
Look, I know you don't need anyone in your hair right now, but...
No, you don't.
Look, I just spent the last 3 days getting everything up there sorted out. It's mostly just composition books, and now that I have them all dated and in order, I don't need to work here, okay? I can take some home and bring them back after I read them.
No!
I'll be careful.
My father wouldn't want anything moved, and I don't want anything to leave this house.
I'll be careful. Someone should read those papers.
I have, and they're garbage.
Garbage? There are 103 notebooks up there.
And I've been through those, and they're gibberish.
Someone else should read them.
No.
Look, I'm gonna be late. Some friends of mine are planning on a bar on Diversity. I told them I'd be there. They're pretty, actually, really low down on the bill. They'll probably go on by 2 or 2:30. Well, actually, you know, they're all in the math department, actually. There's a cool song that's called Lowercase I. They just stand up there and they don't play anything for 3 minutes.
Imaginary number.
Yeah, it's a math joke. Now you see why they're way down on the bill.
Long drive to see a bunch of nerds play in a band.
I hate it when people say that. It's not that long of a drive.
So they are nerds.
Oh, they are raging geeks. But they're, you know, geeks who can dress themselves. They have a job at a major university, and they play sports, they play in a band. They get laid surprisingly often. It really makes you rethink that whole set of terms, you know, nerd, geek, Dilbert, pace eater.
You're a stand, aren't you?
Okay, you got me. I play the drums. You should come watch. I never sing, though, I swear.
No thanks.
Look, Catherine, how about Monday?
Don't you have a job?
Yep, I have a full teaching load this quarter, plus my own work.
Okay.
I don't have the time to do this, but going to. You know, I really loved your dad. I just don't think a mind like his can shut down the way it did. He had lucid moments. He had a whole lucid year 4 years ago.
It wasn't so much of a year. It was more like 9 months.
A school year then. He was advising his students and I was stalling my PhD. I was this close to quitting. And I met with your dad and really put me on the right track again. I owe him.
I'm sorry.
Look, Catherine, you're 25, right?
How old are you?
Doesn't matter, so listen.
Screw you, Hal. How old are you?
Okay, I'm 28, okay? So listen, when your dad was younger than both of us, he made major contributions to three fields. Game theory, algebraic geometry, and nonlinear operator theory. Most of us couldn't get our heads wrapped around that one. And he also gave those astrophysicists something to work over as well.
Don't lecture me.
I'm not, okay? Just listen. I'm saying I could come up with a tenth of the crap that your dad came up with when he was younger than both of us. I could write my own math ticket to any department in this country.
Give me your backpack.
What?
Give me your backpack.
Why?
I want to look inside of it.
Oh, come on.
Open it and give it to me.
I wouldn't do anything. You know that.
You're trying to take one of my father's notes, aren't you?
Well, yeah. I want to publish it.
Then you can write your own ticket.
No, no, it would be in your dad's name. This is all for your dad.
I don't believe you. I think you have one of my father's notebooks in your backpack.
I think you're being a little paranoid.
Paranoid?
Just a little.
Screw you, Hal. I know you have one of my father's notebooks.
I think you should just sit down and think about what you're saying.
I'm saying that you're stealing from my father and my family.
And I'm saying that sounds paranoid.
Just because I'm paranoid doesn't mean that there isn't something in your backpack.
Look, you said it yourself, right? You said there was nothing up there. Didn't you say that?
Yeah.
So what would I steal? Right?
You're right.
Thank you. You know, someone should know for sure whether or not it's up there.
I know this. there's nothing up there. I lived with him. I spent my life with him. I fed him. I took care of him. Talked to him. Talked to him while no one else was there. I had to watch him shuffle around like a ghost. A very smelly ghost. I had to make sure he bathed. My own father.
I'm sorry.
When my mother died, I had to make sure he was happy all the time. He would read all day. I had to get him books by the carload from the library. But then I figured out he wasn't reading. He was convinced that aliens were sending him messages through the Dewey Decimal numbers of the library books.
Well, what kind of message?
Beautiful proofs, wonderful proofs, proofs like music.
Sounds good.
Plus knock-knock jokes and fashion tips. I mean, he was nuts already.
Listen, he was ill, though. It was a tragedy.
And then later, the writing things. He'd be scribbling 19, 20 hours a day. I bought him a case of notebooks. Every single one of them. I dropped out of school. I'm glad he's dead.
Listen, I understand why you feel that way, but I know you.
He's crazy.
Listen, I know you.
No, you don't know me. I want to be left alone. I don't want him here.
Him, I don't.
You, I don't want you here.
But why?
He's dead.
I'm not.
He's dead. I don't want any of his proteges around.
There will be others.
What?
You think I'm the only one? There are already people going through your dad's work. Sooner or later, someone should read those books.
I'll do it.
No.
I'll do it.
No, you can't.
Why not?
You don't have the back. It's all just squiggles on a page to you. You wouldn't know the good stuff from the back.
It's all junk.
No. If it isn't, then we can't afford to miss any through carelessness.
I know mathematics.
Listen, I know your dad taught you some basic stuff, but... Hey! Oh, come on! This isn't an airport. What are you doing?
Come back tomorrow.
You know, the University Health Services is actually really good. I remember when my mom died, my work was stalled, I was pretty shaken up. But then I talked to this doctor and I saw her a couple of times and it really helped me.
I'm fine.
Plus exercise really helps. I jog around the lake a couple of mornings a week. You can join me if you want, I'll pick you up. But I mean, we wouldn't have to talk.
No, thanks.
I'm gonna be late. Actually, it's only 20 minutes to diversity from here. If you want, you can come. We go on and we play. Pretty terrible, but we buy our own drinks afterward to make up for it. You're home by 4:30 tops.
Good night.
Good night.
Wait, your jacket.
No, don't.
I'm paranoid?
No, just listen to me.
You think I should go jogging?
Please, just listen to me.
You stole my father's notebook.
No, I did it for a reason.
I'm sure you did. Okay, I'm calling the police.
No, don't. Just listen to me.
Hello, police? I'd like to report a robbery in progress.
No, will you put that phone down and listen to me?
A robbery.
I did this for you. For you.
I got one thing to sell.
Look, something he wrote. Not Matt, something he wrote about you. See, Kathy. See?
Sal?
I don't know what this refers to, but it says, a good day. Some very good news from Catherine.
When did he write this?
I think 4 years ago. The handwriting is pretty steady, so it must have been during his remission. There's more. The machinery not working yet, but I am patient. The machinery is what he calls mine. His ability to do mathematics.
I know.
There's more. I know I'll get there. I am an auto mechanic who, after years of greasy work on a hopeless wreck, turns the ignition and hears a faint cough. I am not driving yet, but there is eating meals in restaurants, riding buses, all the activities of a normal life. But most of all, Kathy. The years she has lost caring for me. I almost wrote wasted yet. Her refusal to let me be institutionalized. Her keeping me at home, caring for me herself, has certainly saved my life. Made writing is possible. Made it possible to imagine doing math again. Where does her strength come from? I can never repay her. Today's her birthday. She's 21, buying her dinner. Dated September 4th. That's tomorrow.
That's today.
Oh, you're right. I'm sorry. I thought you should read this, and so tomorrow, well, it sounds stupid now, but tomorrow I was gonna wrap this. Happy birthday.